YouTube, this is Chuck Gentles. I want to welcome you back to my channel. Well, it's been an exciting week so far, Lord. You brought us rain. And we also had a forest fire. About 400 acre fire, and they evacuated a bunch of people that were 5 miles away from us. So it was pretty close to us. But we had a big rainstorm. Yesterday and last night was really good and wet everything down. So I'm thinking the fire is probably contained now. They had zero containment on, this is Friday, that was Wednesday. But I think they got most of it. They had slurry bombers and helicopters and whatnot. They're fighting the fire. But so there that was. So we got water. And there might be a little trickle in the creek, so we might be able to go prospecting here pretty soon. Except now, because of the fire, access to the Prescott National Forest is closed to go to Wolf Creek or Turkey Creek, where we usually work. So we can't do that now. Anyhow, that all being said, you're looking at a bunch of stuff in the frying pan here, aren't you? I'll tell you what. That is pewter, believe it or not. I've been messing with pewter for a while. You can't see it there, but you can probably see all this here. Looks like melted lead, but it's not. Because pewter is actually made from tin, antimony, and copper. And that's kind of the current stuff. And back in the days, like in the 1800s, it also had lead and maybe a bismuth. So it's changed now. We have different type of pewter. And it's sometimes hard to figure out if it's pewter or it's aluminum. And some of the ways to test it, if you're like at a thrift store and you're trying to find pewter and you pick up something, it looks like aluminum, but it could be pewter. You can take a brass key and scratch it, and if it gouges into it and soft, it's pewter. If it's pretty hard when you do that, and it doesn't even hardly make a line in it, it's more like a likely an aluminum alloy. And that is one of the tests you can do. The other test you can do is a heat test, because pewter actually melts at a really low temperature. I think it's like 247 to 290 degrees C. So it melts. You can melt it with a propane torch, and that's what all of this is here. This is all melted with a propane torch just to test it. And I've tested multiple things. This was part of something. I don't know what it was, but and this was part of something. Obviously, I melted that also. That was all done with a torch. So we know how to test it, but if you're in the store, they don't allow you to go in there and melt it in the store. So there's certain ones that are really an aluminum alloy, and certain brands. And Countryware is one. Yeah, I look on the back or the bottom. No, I never looked at this one. No. That's more likely pewter the way it melts. Countryware and Wilton are notorious for making it look like pewter, but it's so hard that you can't do anything with it. I mean, you have to melt it like aluminum because it's an aluminum alloy. Another way you can tell in a store is if it has RWP stamped in it. And that way, you don't want to, maybe you do want an aluminum alloy. I don't know. What I'm going to do is melt some pewter. For people who use it, I'll try to make some small bars maybe. And they use it to do all kind of things. Well, they do things like this. They make people out of it. I got a lot of pewter things like this prospector. He's pewter. Here's another pewter thing. I don't know whether it's some kind of metal or a medallion. But that's what they do. They make it out of pewter, and if it's aluminum alloy, they won't take it. So I'd like to try to pour a bar maybe for this and maybe torch melt some of this to get it smaller so you can deal with it. And then we'll take it and melt it into a bar. That's the plan. Long intro, but we'll be back. Yeah, I'm going to show you what the heat test looks like. This is just a Brenzomatic propane torch. And we'll try to melt one of these little pieces here. Oh, let's do this. And see how quickly it melts. It's right there. That's how easy this stuff melts. That's how you know it's pewter. How crusty it got right there. And obviously the cork. But you should be able to get it to dripping in 10 to 15 seconds. But if it's aluminum, you can stand there for hours and it's not going to go. So we'll weigh up some of this stuff before we melt. Now this, I've never tested, so let's do a test on this thing. Looks like a candle holder. Let's go over here, right there. Okay, I'm saying this is not pewter. All right, guys, I just run this through a couple tests. I ground it here. You can see where I ground it, it's still silver. So if this isn't copper, put a magnet on it. It's not any kind of steel or anything. And this is really shiny here, but you can't shine pewter. So I'm guessing this is an aluminum alloy because it's really, really hard. If you look, let's see, where are you? You look right where I scratched it, right here. You can just barely see a line right here where I scratched it. So that means to me that it's really hard and it's not bendable or anything. So I'm guessing this is aluminum alloy. So that's been long enough that it didn't do anything other than wrinkle this, whatever this one is on the other side. So I'm guessing this is aluminum alloy. I'm pretty sure it's aluminum. It's non-magnetic, so those aren't pewter either. So these two, three items are not pewter. This is aluminum alloy, that's aluminum, that's aluminum. No, this is not aluminum. Let me test this one again too. One more time. This is pewter. Alright guys, so we're going to do a melt here, and what I've got two molds down here, on the bottom right there, and there. This is a smaller frying pan that I took all the pewter out of here. There's actually 11 ounces in here, And we're gonna give it a go of melting this. And this frying pan has a notch here. So I think I'll be able to pour from that notch. I might have to change bottles and go to nap gas, because this one's pretty low. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna do that right now. Be back. We got the nap gas. Bottle almost on, valve's open. The only reason I'm using map gas is it'll be faster than propane. Like propane. There we go. So what's happened here is a lot of this has a lot of dross on it from paints and glues and whatnot, and that's why it wasn't melting here. This is all dross. Well, some of it, like that's on my finger. This is still good. We'll melt this, and some of this over here will melt. It's trying to go, and we'll try to get some of the dross out of there too at the same time. So I moved the pan around a little bit, so I got some of the dross to run out. I mean, the pewter to run out of the dross, so. Bad bar. Ah, dear, I'm sorry. Let's see. What can we do here? Let's see what happens when I turn this over. What falls out? Anything? It would have been a nice bar, it looks like. If I had poured in on top of it. I know better than that. Oh, it's not, it didn't fasten, so we're all right. We double melded right there. Guys, this is going to be the second attempt. Well, I guess it's the third attempt at a bar. So let me do this, get that right up there. And we're good to go. Okay. So, here we go again. Thank you. cover over, and this is still a lot of, there's a little bit of pewter in this, yeah. Okay, so this is the first attempt at pewter. And was it successful? It melted. That's all I can say is it melted. So we'll just dump the amount here. Get it. They might be too hot yet. We'll let them sit for a minute. Hey guys, so I'm not used to pewter or aluminum alloys other than aluminum bronze, which I've made before, but you can see this is dross in there. That's dross, it's not any good. And I dropped the bar on the fire brick and it broke. So I'm not sure what that means for sure, because like I say, I've worked with aluminum and brass and bronze and all kinds of different metals, gold, silver, done pours, not done pewter, and this is why I guess I don't know exactly how to do it. So when it breaks like this, somebody let me know what you think. When it breaks, does that have more of an aluminum alloy in it, or is it pewter? Let me know. Thank you so much. And okay, so anyhow, if you like this video, which I'm not sure you will, give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe, come back again. Give a great comment, and thank you so much for watching. You guys stay safe out there and stay blessed. See you on the next one.